Hi everyone, welcome to a brief introduction to causal inference. In this talk, I'll be giving you a preview of the first few weeks of the course. My main goal is to focus on motivation and intuition. This talk isn't meant to give you a complete understanding of all of the topics that I cover. I'm going to try to cover a decent number of topics so that you'll get a good idea of what some of the basics of causal inference are, but you won't get a complete understanding of these topics until the first few weeks of the course. You might have in mind some machine learning topics like out-of-distribution generalization, and you might be interested in how causal inference is related to those. Those won't appear in this talk because they're not some of the basics of causal inference, but they will appear later in the course. All right, so with that, let's get started. What is causal inference? Causal inference is mainly about inferring the effect of one thing on another thing. So you could be inferring the effect of any treatment, policy, or intervention, for example. Some examples are if you want to infer the effect of a treatment on a disease, or say you want to reduce emissions, and you have multiple different climate change policies to do this. You might want to pick the policy that is most effective at reducing emissions, so it causes the largest reduction in emissions. Similarly, say you notice that there is this rising mental health bad outcomes, and you think that social media might be one of the important causes of this. So you could try to do a causal analysis to see how important social media is in contributing to this problem, maybe what percentage of the problem it contributes. And there's many more. So just generally, if you have any X that you want to talk about the effect of on some Y, that's what causal inference is for. So here is the outline slide. We're first going to give a motivating example, which is Simpsons Paradox. You might have heard of this before, and it turns out that the causal structure of the problem is absolutely essential in resolving Simpsons Paradox. Then we'll talk about why correlation does not imply causation. You've probably heard this before, but hopefully I'll give you a bit more understanding of why this is the case and what kind of important implications this has. And then in the last part of the talk, we'll talk about observational studies. So an observational study is when you just are given data, you're not able to make any experiments. And this is where a lot of causal inference research takes place these days.